So to get started here again, Dynamics 365 for phones is available through the iOS App Store as well. You can get it on Google Play for your Android devices. If you do want to go to the web browser versions of those app stores before you install the app, you can do a quick compatibility check to make sure your mobile device is able to run the Dynamics 365 for phones app. But for the most part, it will install on just about any iOS iPhone. And for the most part, the Android devices that are in market and popular today can handle the Dynamics 365 for Phones app. The image here on the right-hand side of the slide is just a quick snipping of the Android App Store. I did want to show you there are a lot of different Dynamics 365 apps available in the market and in the App Store, if you will. But it's important to always download the one that comes from the Microsoft Corporation and the one that's labeled Dynamics 365 for phones. All right, so we're going to jump into a demonstration next. If you'll bear with me here for just a quick second, I'm going to bring up an Android phone on screen, and I'll show you how to find, download, and get our Dynamics 365 app for phones up and running. Okay, here we are. Here's my Android phone pulled up here, just sort of a demo device that I have set up. And we'll go ahead here and launch the Android App Store. And I've already typed in Dynamics 365, again, just to show you the variety of results that you're going to get when you do search Dynamics 365 in the App Store. Here you can see CRM for phones, for sales, app are some of the different results. Again, it's Dynamics 365 for phones. That's the labeled name of the app. And we want to grab the one that comes from Microsoft Corporation. In this case, it's already installed on my Android device, so I do have the option to apply some updates here. But you can see as we scroll through the App Store, there's Microsoft Dynamics 365 Unified Operations. There's warehousing, project service automation, some of the Business Central, some of the more legacy CRM for phones Express apps. So again, when you do search for Dynamics or Dynamics 365 in your App Store, be sure to grab Dynamics 365 for phones, and it's the app from the publisher Microsoft Corporation. All right, let's go ahead and launch the Dynamics 365 for phones app now. Again, here I'm just in the home screen of my Android, and I have the icon pinned to my home screen, top row, second from the left. We'll just launch it here. And now the very first thing that the app's going to want is your Dynamics 365 web address. So if you launch your CRM, if you launch Dynamics 365 customer engagement in a web browser on your PC, it's going to be the URL from the address bar of the screen. So in this case here, my instance is labeled crm063371.crm.dynamics.com. So I've just picked that out and added it to the app here. We click the next arrow. Now it's going to ask us for our login. This might be our Office 365 account, or if we're just using Dynamics 365, this will be your email address and password that you regularly use to sign into Dynamics 365. I'm just going to skip ahead here and log in really quickly. All right, so the first time we log into the app here after entering our email address, our username and password, we're presented with all the published apps that are part of our Dynamics 365 collection. So you may have lots, as I do here in the example tenant, or you may have just a few, maybe just sales and customer service, or maybe some of the custom power apps if you do have a partner that builds those for you. So in this case, we're going to go into the Sales Hub, as that's sort of the modern CRM component of Dynamics 365. And the app here is just going to take a moment or two to load up the unified interface for our CRM application. Once we log in and everything's loaded up, you'll see already the unified interface, sort of the beauty of this design at work. Now, we're presented with our dashboard, sort of the first thing as we logged in as our workspace here on the mobile device. And that's great because you really can pick up where you left off, sort of after you left your desk and now you're on the go. Anything that you've sort of flagged, or even if you've customized some of your dashboards, you can actually get all of this information on the go. So in this particular example, we have our opportunities, our activities, we have all of our open leads, all of our active accounts, we have our sales pipeline here, a visual representation of our funnel, visual representation of our open opportunities. So you can see in quite a rich way, anything that we can have on the web browser version of Dynamics 365, we can have with us on the phone. You just maybe have to do a little bit more scrolling as far as the layout goes, but everything's here at our fingertips as we need it while we are away from our desk. Now, where the one big difference is around navigation. In the mobile app, you're going to find yourself going to the bottom of your phone screen quite frequently. There's a back arrow, a left arrow that takes you back to the last screen you were on. We do have the infamous hamburger menu here, which brings up the left-hand menu that you would see on the web version. And you've heard me talk before, if you do want to customize this menu, maybe you want to take out this Adobe sign, maybe you want to take out your collateral and marketing, you can customize this company-wide, or you can customize this for each user if you want as well. Additionally, when clicking on the hamburger menu, you do see that we are in the sales app for Dynamics 365. You have your settings and you have a help menu available here down at the bottom as well. Also, we've got the home button I just tapped there, and that's going to bring us back to the dashboards. In this case, Agreements Main is set as our default dashboard, so that's kind of our home screen, if you will. We've also got a search button here, and that's searching across the entire Dynamics 365 tenant. And then we do have task flows, so if you want to change your password, if you want to update a contact, these are task flows. These ones happen to be out of the box. After meeting here, this one, for example, is quite popular. Just a quick task after a meeting to add notes to a lead, to a contact, to an opportunity. You can search here for the appointment, and the app will bring up all of the associated records. As well, there's always the three dots, the ellipse, the more actions command button. We do have the relationship assistance if you want to see upcoming actions that you need to take on a particular account. One of my favorite tools in the interface here is the quick create menu, where you can create just about any type of entity record here within Dynamics. Again, very customizable, so if you don't use products, if you don't use playbooks, you can get rid of these just to keep the interface a little bit clean and easy to use. There are settings, personalization settings and notification settings. So if you're like me and you take this app home with you on your personal device and you don't want notifications after a certain hour, you certainly can do that as well. And then Microsoft has designed this interface around creating new things rather quickly. So if you do want to create a new activity, being a task, being something you need to do when you get back to the office in front of a larger screen, you can book all of those things here from your phone, or you can create a new record, a new account, new contact, new product, new service. As you are sort of out in the world using your phone, you can do all of that in a rather quick way here with the unified interface on the Dynamics 365 app for phones. So as you can see here, with the use of the unified interface, Microsoft's really brought a lot of power to users that are on the go and not perhaps in front of a proper screen and keyboard and mouse. You do have a lot of power here at your fingertips to still get things done on the go as far as it would relate to CRM. So let me give you a few sort of use examples here. If you wanted to add leads, perhaps you've met someone at a trade show and you do want to quick create a lead, that's relatively easy within a few taps. Now, any of the default fields that you've already set with your leads entity, here you can set a topic where you met the person, who they are, how to contact them, and it's as easy as tapping that information in and hit save and close. If you do find you're a little bit more adept to use a keyboard, I know there's a lot of Bluetooth keyboards available on the market that you can pair with your phone. So again, if you're at a trade show, for example, and you do want to get leads into your system really quickly, you know, you can do that at the trade show, or you can perhaps do that at the restaurant after the trade show floor is closed. As well, you can pull up information on any opportunity that exists already in the system. So if you're a traveling salesperson and you're going out to visit, let's say AdventureWorks here to talk about the printers, you can see everything that's relevant about this opportunity before you walk in the door. So little secret, little story about myself. We used to use a similar application, and we used to run a laptop in the car as we traveled across the country making sales. We would quickly read up on all of the notes before we went in to see our customers. So gives you a good view of the history, gives you a good view of everything you've been discussing about where the opportunity is as far as the stage where we talked about qualify, develop, propose, and close. You know, really everything's right here at your fingertips, so no need to carry around a big laptop and power it in the car with a battery and connect to home office. Everything's right here at your fingertips. And so this comes down really to one important thing is encouraging your colleagues who are in the CRM and in the sales tools with you to get this app on their phones and get exploring. There's no right or wrong way certainly to use it, and you're not going to break anything by connecting to it. For those administrators and sales managers tuning into the webinar today, you can set a lot of security restrictions. So if you want certain members to have the app, certain access restrictions as far as what information can be accessed by the app, that is all available through security roles in Dynamics 365. That's quite robust. And at the end of the day, it's all tied back to your Office 365 login, your email address, and password. So if a user does leave your organization, it's very easy for you to turn off their access quite quickly. The app still may stay installed on their phone, but nothing will be saved, and none of your company information will be at risk, so to speak. That's all the material I had planned to show you today. Just a quick recap of the webinar so far. We discussed the Dynamics 365 for Phone app, which is available for iOS and Android devices. Very easy to deploy and very secure for those sales managers that want to sort of bolt down their internal sales practices and keep the information as close to safe as possible. The unified interface everywhere, again, what you see on the web and any customizations that you make to Dynamics 365, you can rest assured that you're not going to have to spend a lot of time and effort redoing that to your mobile applications as well. It's sort of a design once, use everywhere philosophy. And that's really great, cuts down on training time and cuts down on time to make changes everywhere. A lot of customizations are possible, so as much as we talk about having a good partner to help you change the interface that you would use for Dynamics 365 on the web, again, equally important to have a good partner that can help you sort of trim down things on the phone app and help keep your mobile sales team as efficient and effective as possible as they're out in the world selling your products and services.